Have you ever wondered what goes on in downtown Santa Cruz on Halloween? In this edition of Moving Forward, we will not only take you there, but to two other great events that happened in Santa Cruz County on that Halloween weekend. Halloween, October 31st, has a rich and interesting history. The word Halloween is a shortening of All Hallows Evening. Halloween can be traced back about 2,000 years to a pre-Christian Celtic festival held around November 1st, called Samhain, which means summer's end in Gaelic. The exact nature of Samhain is not fully understood, but it was an annual communal meeting at the end of the harvest year, a time to gather resources for the winter months and bring animals back from the pastures. Samhain was a time used by the ancient pagans to take stock of supplies and prepare for winter. This harvest festival would frequently involve bonfires. It is believed that the fires attracted insects to the area, which in turn attracted bats to the area. These are additional attributes of the history of Halloween. Samhain is also thought to have been a time of communing with the dead. There was a belief that it was a day when spirits of the dead would cross over into the other world. Ancient Gaelic people believed that the boundaries between the worlds of the living and the dead overlapped, and the deceased would come back to life and cause havoc on October 31st, such as sickness or damaged crops. Halloween beliefs and customs were brought to North America with the earliest Irish immigrants. Masks and costumes were worn in an attempt to mimic the evil spirits or to appease them. The tradition of dressing in costumes and trick-or-treating may go back to the practice of mumming and guising, in which people would disguise themselves and go door-to-door asking for food. The practice of dressing up in costumes and begging door-to-door for treats on holidays goes back to the Middle Ages and includes Christmas wassailing.
Hating people!
Friends of mine! Those are being scary people!
Scary? Not
now.
Scary!
Trick-or-treat!
Trick-or-treating resembles the late medieval practice of souling, when poor folk would go door-to-door on Hallowmas, November the 1st, receiving food in return for prayers for the dead on All Souls Day, November 2nd. Trick-or-treating didn't start in the United States until World War II. Today, the trick part of the phrase trick-or-treat is mostly an empty threat. But pranks have long been a part of the holiday. By the late 1800s, the tradition of playing tricks on Halloween was well established. In the United States and Canada, the pranks included tipping over outhouses, opening farmers' gates, and egging houses. But by the 1920s and 30s, the celebrations more closely resembled an unruly block party, and the acts of vandalism got more serious.
Pranks on people, and yeah, it's about the spooky unknown elements of the night, the things you can't see getting to you.
It's the one day a year where you get to be what you're usually not, at least that's how I take it, so I get to dress up in a way that I don't usually dress up, so. I'm usually a little bit more not showing legs, but today's the past.
I wear superhero costumes every day. What are you talking about?
Thank you.
And, oh. Right?
Well, I was just thinking it's kind of like
a Wiccan Mardi Gras, because tonight is kind of the party that we do, and then tomorrow is Samhain, and tomorrow is kind of quiet and a little more sacred, and yeah, like I'm keeping the rain away.
Actually,
it's all me. I'm sure. My husband and I met at a Halloween party. He was dressed like Batman, and I was dressed like a space princess. And 3 years later, we got married and have two children. So this is our thing.
It's like an anniversary.
It is. Our anniversary is on the 26th. 23 years.
Congratulations.
Thank you. So this is kind of our thing. I feel fabulous.
Very regal. My daughter.
It's a time for kids, for adults to let their inner child come out, to have fun, for the community all to come together, to just celebrate. Celebrate being silly, celebrate being someone else or something else, even a jellyfish.
We're not able to make the tryouts.
We're kind of the rejects.
Yeah, we're like gospel. Have a good time.
It means All Hallows Eve. That was a holiday that our ancestors had before the Romans conquered Europe.
Hello.
Well, we didn't have any costumes, and the church said, here you go.
I don't care what they may do. Jesus is just all right. My songs. Jesus is just all right. By my.
All right.
Are you guys a choir?
Yeah.
I love it.
Why, yes. Thank you for inspiring.
What is Halloween? Dad? This is a spirit of sorts. Yeah, it goes. Mosquito net. I'm a bug catcher.
Spirituality, because spirit to all is spiritual. All of us are worthy of spirit. Okay, so the Shakespearean question, to be or not to be, that is the question.
The day of the dead, right? So, I don't know.
It'll be
All Hallows Eve.
No, you're not. I'm very disappointed in her. Just philosophically
messed
up.
And he keeps trying to tempt me, and you know it's not working so far. I have Batman here with me, so Batman, he actually is extra help to ward off the evil.
Halloween, to keep it simple, is a time for us to have fun, pretend, and be something that we're not. It's about family, being creative, creating memories.
And awesome costumes.
Yeah. Uniting with the community.
And right?
And enjoying it with our children.
I think empowered. I think as women, we want to see ourselves in strong roles and we live it constantly. And Halloween is a time to really let out our alter egos.
There we go. Well, we really enjoy making it work. And I think we did a great job this year.
We feel creative. We feel like we met our goals.
Yeah, it's a great team.
Okay.
I believe it is dead night. I'm glad you're my children.
Every Halloween, I dress up as some person I know from history or, I don't know, growing up, listening to music, just different icons. So Halloween means to me. I love it.
Best holiday of the year.
It means dressing up and having fun.
Yeah, exactly.
Showing your creativity.
All about a good time.
I made these starting once last Saturday. I got the idea offline and kind of went crazy with it. And here we go.
Cosmic jellyfish.
Cosmic jellyfish. They're from the movie How to Train Your Dragon. I'm Astrid, he's Hiccup, and I just thought the movie was really cool and had to do it for Halloween. My mom made my costumes every year, every Halloween growing up, whatever I wanted to be.
God,
she stopped making them at a certain point, and I just kept doing it and wanted to carry it on, so I made them myself now.
She spent months making both these costumes, and they turned out really well. Fat, mostly. I can't gain weight at all on these.
Tight already.
So are these got 101 Dalmatians?
Yes.
Five.
Only five.
We lost 95.
Peanut butter and jelly?
Yes.
Honestly, because it was the cheapest costume and adorable, must say, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. We are a sandwich.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise.
We worked on our costumes for like the whole month of October. He wanted to be Frankenstein, so I'll be his bride. So our werewolf, our mummy, and our Dracula.
Time to have fun and express who you are, and just be you. It's cold and revealing, and I wish I had a jacket, but it's fun and everybody likes it, so it makes me happy.
I hate spiders.
The itsy bitsy spider ran up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out.
You seep into our ears, for Shakespeare said, wisdom sleeps in the ears of a fool. So we have connected the north, the south, the east, and the west.
I feel like the king bee, honestly. As a bee, my life is to gorge honey and go out, and hopefully a queen bee wants me to impregnate her, at which point my thing falls off into her and I die. That's all a male bee's life is about. So to me, that's what it's all about.
I'm Mr. Softy, the mascot from the Mr. Softy like ice cream truck. And this was from a wire trash can from Dollar Tree.
It's just right there with Christmas. I love it.
Did you do your own makeup?
That's it. Love it. But no, it's fun. It's fun. When it's raining, it's the perfect costume. It just fades paint. You can wear whatever you want. It just made the evening fun for us.
I am forced to do this. If it were my way, I'd be at home watching a movie, having a drink.
Halloween is fun. Halloween is great. Halloween is a time to
find a
date. And if I don't find a date, I'll date myself.
Speak loudly and clearly.
Halloween means getting out, going downtown, and dressing really thick.
We're jocks.
Hopefully spending way too much money on all kinds of costumes. It's worth it.
Worth it.
How do these condoms suspend?
Constricted.
Constricted, oh, definitely.
Constricted.
Thank you.
Divine love you all so much. You are all precious children of Father, Mother, God. The love is like a thousand universes big. So much love, that's how much God loves you. You are so beautiful. Each of you. What? Absolutely. Sometimes I think God likes gay people a little bit more. So keep that one under the covers.
Say is that God made me to party.
Follow that. What a beautiful.
Not knowing who we are, now we have identified ourselves and become an individual.
Joy,
sparkly.
We're the Spark Sisters.
In the name of love, before you break my heart.
Stop.
In the name of love, before you break my heart.
Representing prisoners that could be any one of us taken off the streets under the National Defense Authorization Act by the military and held permanently in secret prisons without trial and without attorney, without a call home. And so we are organizing a constitutional protection zone in Santa Cruz, and we have Chris Hedges coming on Sunday, November 23rd. He's one of the plaintiffs in the case against Obama about this issue.
We're just doing whatever the hell you want us to do.
What does Halloween mean to you?
Halloween? It means just having fun.
Yeah.
I mean,
it doesn't matter how old you are, just have fun.
Exactly. Just have fun and be safe. Stay in school, kids.
Yes, we'll be counting stars.
His life, swinging blind, swing my heart across the line, in my face is flashing signs, he shall find me, but I'm not that old, I don't care for the soul, just do what we told you.
I feel something so right,
Everything that kills me makes me come alive.
I'll tell you what Halloween means to me.
I know.
We see our reflection in all people. And this is before the compartmentalization of thought through religion. This is when we lived in symbiosis with nature.
Halloween is a fun time to dress up. And
I'm Roger Rabbit.
And who is she?
This is my lovely wife. Yes,
I made my costume, so I'm really proud of it. I hand sewed it, so it makes me feel good.
She worked really hard at the end, and I feel really good.
You know something I learned last year or a year ago? But apparently in lingerie stores, Halloween sales surpass Valentine's Day sales. What it should mean is a carnival atmosphere where people let free in a safe environment, but it allows people to step into their alter egos.
Really nice.
And I've been Frida for 3 years in a row now, so I thought it's time for something else.
So you know, we came out here because out in Oakland, it's scary. You know what I'm saying? Too many gunshots. So we came here because, you know, we got trained. We got trained, first of all. Then second of all, trying to live my life. I'm having a good ass time.
I like tennis.
Can you say something about women in sports, please?
We play good!
And we's educated! Goodbye!
With scholastics, we could do anything.
I'm the one who asks the questions here. I'm the reporter. See, I have the microphone. What does Holly mean to you? Important. Like, people have to listen to me because I have a microphone. And I say words into it.
According to local news reports, this tennis player, also known as Corey, told this Fox how much he hated Fox News. He then allegedly stole his microphone and hit the Fox with his tennis racket. When police closed in, Corey took flight, but was finally caught and arrested. No charges have been confirmed, but the attractive young man's mugshot went viral as the latest hot mugshot guy.
And answers the question, to be or not to be, by Gandhi, the change you wish to see in the world. To be or not to be, the change you wish to see in the world, that is the question.
Halloween means everything. It's my life. I don't live if there's no Halloween. Period.
I agree.
The Museum of Art and History celebrated Dia de los Muertos, or the Day of the Dead, with a free event including music, food, folkloric dancing, skeleton makeup, and ended with a procession to our local Evergreen Cemetery. The Day of the Dead celebrations may seem similar to Halloween, but there are big differences between the holiday that promotes fear of the dead and the holiday that celebrates the dead. The Day of the Dead holiday is about celebrating the dead, not being afraid of the dead. It's a holiday for people to honor their ancestors and loved ones who have passed away and invite those spirits back into their homes to be part of the family once more. It's a celebration of family and a show of respect. The practice of celebrating the dead goes back thousands of years in South American cultures. November 1st and 2nd are national holidays in Mexico and other South American countries. During those days, people welcome back the spirits of deceased family members. They tend to their graves, cleaning up graveyards, planting flowers and trees, and leaving offerings at the graves. They also wear the clothes of their deceased relatives, paint their faces as skulls, or wear skeleton masks or costumes, and build altars in their homes to honour their loved ones. And the same foods and drinks that the family members loved in life are placed on the altars alongside marigold flowers to draw the spirits of the family members who have crossed over. Marigolds are said to attract spirits, so they are visible everywhere during Day of the Dead celebration. Hundreds marched through Watsonville, calling for peace and community mobilization to help stop violence. A group of mothers led local residents, community groups, churches, businesses, police, and unions to remember and honor the lives of local residents who have lost their lives to domestic and street violence.
My name is Manuel Rivas, and I'm the co-chair of the Peace and Unity March. Do you think this is the way to, you know, go about moving this community towards nonviolence? This approach that we're taking is just involving more people in the community, more agencies, more organizations specifically that deal with, youth violence prevention. For the first time, the city of Watsonville is the sponsor of the march. So we're getting a lot of support from them, especially the Parks and Recreation. It's the first time we have a banner announcing the march across the main street. I mean, that's a great spot to let the community know that there is an important event. The city of Watsonville has embraced the march as, you know, its own, and it's great to be working with everybody.
Okay, my name is Debbie Aguilar, and I said, you know what, I'm not alone, but I still hurt. What am I going to do after this day? It feels good today, but what about tomorrow? I was in deep grief, so I said I was going to form a support group, didn't know how, didn't know when or where, because I'm a mother with her son on her t-shirt with tears in her eyes. But I voiced it just came out of nowhere, and it came to pass. It came to fruition. We have been supporting mothers and their families since 2003, a time for grieving and healing, because essentially we have to grieve. You have to grieve. If you don't grieve, it's going to be waiting for you at the end of the tunnel anyways. So my way of healing, part of my healing was reaching out and being active in my community and offering emotional, spiritual support, going to the crime scenes to be there with the mother and the family who doesn't know what to do because their child is behind the yellow tape and you're not allowed. We do prison, we go to the institutions. Now, we've just done so much, and I'd rather, it's not to give myself accolades or group, but it's because it's needed. Mothers are the heart of the community.
I do this in memory of my son since he died in June of 1994. And I do this because I have him in my heart.
Yeah.
And I would want people to know that he was killed. And I want him to be living in everybody's minds, but for me especially, because he's my son. And I like to bring out the message for the people to understand that it's a very bad situation that was going on here in Watsonville. You know, it's not only Watsonville, but every other county, towns and everything. But whether it's ringing or not, we're still going to be going on for the march. And we do this every year, and I hope that every year I'm here still to be able to represent my son, that I love him so much.